In this video, I'm going to go over how to calculate molecular weight and molar mass. And so the first thing is that molecular weight and molar mass are found the same way. The only difference is the units you use at the end of the problem. And so the formula for both of these is you take the atomic weight of an element, and then you multiply that by how many you have in that molecule. And we have to do this for every element, and then we add them all together. And so let's start off with a basic example of just H2O of water. And so we're going to need the atomic weight of both of these, so hydrogen and oxygen. So we get that from the periodic table. And so just pulling in these two squares and remembering that the atomic weight is our number down here. And just a quick overview of atomic weight. This is basically the average of what this element weighs in the universe. So we're not saying that every oxygen weighs 15.999, but we're saying that on average, that's what oxygen weighs. And that's because there's different isotopes. There's oxygens out there that weigh a little bit more and a little bit less than 15.99, and they all average out to this. All right, and so now here's how I like to set up my calculations. So basically I have my formula for each element, and now I'm gonna do them all and add them together. So the atomic weight of hydrogen, we just take that from here, 1.0078. And then we use our subscript. This 2 is referring to hydrogen, so it's saying that water has 2 hydrogens. And so multiplying together, we get 2.0156. All right, so now for oxygen, atomic weight, 15.999. We don't see any subscript here, which means it's an implied 1. So our subtotal here is just 15.999. And now we just add them together. So we get 18.015, and it's up to you how many sig figs you have to use. That really depends on a per problem basis. And so now we get into the difference between molecular weight and molar mass. So the number for both of them is going to be 18.015. But for molecular weight, we'd say our answer is AMU. And this stands for atomic mass unit. And for molar mass, we'd say our units is grams per mole. So grams, a little division sign, and then mole. And so in your class, your teacher is going to go over both of these concepts and when you need to use which one. But the number will always be the same. The only difference is the units. And the units, of course, mean different things. But in terms of calculating it, which is what this video is focused on, it's the same number. You find it the same way. All right, now let's do another example. It's a little bit more complicated. So what's the molecular weight slash molar mass of aluminum sulfate? And so for this, we have to have the molecular formula of aluminum sulfate, which is Al2SO43. And so now we have to really figure out, okay, how many of each of our element do we have? That's going to be really important for all these problems. This one's a little bit more complicated. So our subscript of 2 for aluminum is here. So we just have these 2 aluminums. And so for sulfur, we have to look at these parentheses. And what these parentheses mean is that we actually have 3 SO4 units. So when I look at it, I see this. I see, okay, that parentheses means that we have 3 little chunks of SO4. And so now after we've drawn it out, we can see, oh, okay, I have 1, 2, 3 sulfurs. The other way to do that is just to do the multiplying subscripts route. So we have our secret invisible 1 subscript of sulfur, which is right there, and then we'd have to multiply that by the 3. So overall, we could have also gotten to 3 by just saying 1 times 3, because those were the 2 subscripts that applied to sulfur. All right, and so for oxygen, again, looking out and saying, well, we have this 4 here, but we also have this 3 outside the parentheses. So what we really have is, back to our 3 little chunks of SO4, we have 4 plus 4 plus 4, so that's going to be to 12. And the other way we can do that is, again, multiplying the subscripts. So I could have just said, well, 4 applies to oxygen right here, and 3 also applies to oxygen right here, so I can just multiply 4 times 3 and also get to 12. All right, so now that I have that, I'm going to need the atomic weights, so just pulling those 3 periodic table boxes right here. And now I'm ready to go ahead and do my math and add everything up. So aluminum, 26.982, and I have 2 of them. Multiplying them together, I get 53.964. And so next, sulfur, 32.065. I have three of them, so multiplying together I have 96.195. And last but not least, oxygen, 15.999. I have 12 of them. Multiplying together, I have 191.988. So now, just adding those all together, I chose to use 5 sig figs. I have 342.15. And now, let's again do our breakdown of molecular weight slash molar mass. So it's going to be the same number for both of them. If we're saying molecular weight, that's going to be in atomic mass units, AMUs. And if we're saying molar mass, we're going to do grams over moles. All right, so that's how you can calculate any molecular weight or any molar mass. It's all this same formula. Hope this was helpful and happy studying. Hey, I hope you liked that video. Please feel free to subscribe, click around and watch my other tutorials. And as always, happy studying.